What will fuel the cars of the future? The same stuff that makes the stars shine. Hey there, guys. It's Jonathan Strickland with Forward Thinking. I'm still here at CES 2014. I've been invited into the Toyota booth. Now, Toyota is one of our partners, and they've been showing off some really incredible stuff here, including some concept vehicles that frankly blow my mind. But I really want to talk to you about fuel cell technology. Now, this isn't a new technology. We've known about it for more than a century, but it's a really cool one. Imagine that you've got a chamber. On one side of that chamber, you have hydrogen. On the other side of the chamber, you have oxygen. And in between the two, you've got a membrane. Now, this membrane only allows positively charged ions to flow through, so the hydrogen normally can't get through there. But when it comes into contact, a catalyst causes the hydrogen to lose an electron. It becomes a positively charged ion, passes through the membrane. Now, all those electrons don't like each other, and they want to get back with their hydrogen buddies, so you open up a pathway, a circuit that these electrons can flow through, thus creating electricity. They go through the circuit, and on the other side, they rejoin with the hydrogen and oxygen, and then you get water, good old H2O. In fact, a fuel cell only generates three things: water, heat, and electricity. So, why has this technology not spanned the globe? Well, we've had some big challenges to face. Two of them were cost and building out an infrastructure where we could actually fuel up a vehicle that runs on a hydrogen fuel cell.
We were lucky enough to catch up with the people behind the scenes of Toyota's fuel cell technology.
This is a very exciting time where I get to be involved in developing the future. You know, and I don't know if a lot of people get to say that, and I feel very lucky and fortunate for that. And it's a time where we can be very creative in solving these problems, because I mean, this is an engineering problem. I'm an engineer, and you know, but it's fun to be able to be creative in solving these problems and finding solutions for sustainable technology for the future.
And we're not talking about the distant future. Toyota and the state of California and several other organizations are working together to build out fueling stations to support a fleet of up to 10,000 cars. So this future technology we've been talking about for years, we're gonna see it happen. And it's not 5 years from now, it's not 10 years from now. They're going to be launching this concept vehicle in 2015.
The best part about fuel cells, from my point of view, is that they transcend all sorts of classes of vehicles, and they do other kinds of things as well too. So you can imagine having a fuel cell powering your home. In fact, it already happens in Japan.
This vehicle could power a house. So after the tsunami in Japan, there's a real concern of how can we provide power in an emergency situation. And we have a perfect solution here. We have a way to generate quality power for up to a week.
Or you go to work and you use a fuel cell forklift, or you leave your car at the bus station and you take a fuel cell bus.
The entire group is as excited as we are, and sometimes we forget because you're just doing the daily thing to make the vehicle better. And then once in a while, when you step back and you reflect on what you're doing and what you want to leave and what you want to contribute, and seeing the hydrogen car driving around and having these gorgeous zero-emission fun vehicles driving all over and knowing that you're kind of at the forefront of that.
This is it. This is where we want to be, you know, for the next 100 years. We can't imagine a better future than to have these things everywhere.
As soon as we're done with this show, we are going back to test. I mean, we're developing this vehicle. This is a production cycle. We have a schedule.
Now, clearly I'm excited about this technology. I can't help it. It's incredible to me. Personally, I can't wait to drink a nice, big, tall, frosty glass of fuel cell exhaust because it is pure water. And as we all know, it's not the years, it's the mileage. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure you share it with your friends. And once you're done with all that hard work, reward yourself. Take a break. Watch some of these videos too.